all together. If you are in the doorway, feel free to come this way. There are various seats around here. If you had an empty seat next to you for the last presentation that hasn't been filled, please raise your hand. There are empty seats. If anybody wants to come forward, please do.
Before you go, one more event. If you can't make it to the Creative Play fundraiser, which is what should be your priority. There is a march at 5:30 today starting at the Detroit on Central Avenue and 2nd Street to support independent businesses. The mayor will be leading that. He will be issuing a special proclamation at 5:30, and then folks are going to march from there, 2nd and Central, all the way to 31st and Central. So do bring your walking shoes.
And your bags.
Absolutely.
Many people struggle with consistency, voice control, lifestyle change. You can't really control that. Some people eat more than they should. Some people aren't consistently happy. And it's hard to change your lifestyle when you do that. And this is an analysis collected from 2007 to 2014 that 70% of Americans are overweight or obese. Another problem is the majority of people in the U.S. have become discouraged when it comes to their health and fitness. They'll do a little bit of it, probably go for about two to three weeks, and then they'll get discouraged and just stop. That's a big problem. They have to keep going, and if they have their partner, he's going to help them get motivated, and you've got to help each other stay motivated. About two out of every three Americans are already released, have climbed to 7%, means millions more have been given up on diet. Problem number three. Loneliness and accountability is one of the main reasons people cite they don't work out. So being lonely, it's not really, you really shouldn't be sad about that. Like, I feel like you should come together, and it also helps loneliness because you meet more people, you meet with your partner, and if you don't have the right curvy with your partner, then should be able to help you out. So you guys have to help each other out and bring, like, pull each other up through the whole entire fight of being active. And if you're not used to this and if you're not, like, in shape, then that's the whole process of the balance. So you really have to get used to the whole fitness plan. You have to get used to your meal plan. You have to get used to eating healthy and whatever. The solution. We're going to solve problem number one by having a specific meal plan and tips on how to stay consistent. We're also solving problem number two by staying on the routine for just three. For just 3 weeks, and the results you will see should give you the encouragement you need to continue the course. So within just 3 weeks, by eating healthy and working out and going out and doing things active and being happy, you're going to see major results. And last but not least, we're going to solve problem number three by matching and choosing a partner by going to the website and entering your info. Doing this, your partner can know a little bit about you, and you guys can even meet for coffee and just get to know each other so you can really figure it out. And they're going to have a background on their website, so our competition is Points to Your Fitness, For You Fitness, and Fitness. You know, I love that gym. I go to that gym all the time. And pretty much any small group-based workout companies, like in the year. Our product is, that's what I'm want my third shirt to look like. Probably it's going to be a little bit more pop in it. Like, I'm probably going to add some designs on it. But that's just the basic right there. Like, I'm going to have my website in mind. What makes us awesome? We show you how to get shape for your body type. Like, whatever body shape you want, we're going to try to help you get to that point. Free videos at no cost on the website. We're going to have together routines, videos on how to work together with each other on the website. Affordable merchandise, new plans and tips on what foods you should stay away from. So, we're going to have tips and foods of what you shouldn't do and what foods target, like, what part of your body. So, we're going to have that on there too. Our revenue channels, selling money, selling monthly fitness boxes. So, soon enough, we're going to have fitness boxes filled with fitness equipment that will be shipped to your house monthly, and it's just a monthly pay that you have to get that. We're going to do personal training. We're going to also sell off the merchandise, that is shirts, soon enough, and affiliate merchandise off the website. Okay. Our long-term goal is to own my own gym in a couple of years, so be able to sell our merchandise out of the gym for anyone who comes there, and help people get in shape is the main goal. So, how you can help is share your contact info and when you did have coffee, and introductions to potential brands and influencers who can help. Just need help with how to do this, some tips, and yeah, that's it.
So first and foremost, this is incredibly impressive that you're 15. I love that your parents, your family are letting you live within your passion. And if you continue doing this, you will go far. You're incredibly brave for doing this and really have motivated you. So I think this is how you I just recently lost 55 pounds and am going through all this process myself, and I can tell you that you're hitting on something, on a nerve with me, because a large part of this is being afraid of being alone or being afraid of putting it out there that I'm fat and I need to lose weight. You know what I'm saying? I need to get healthy. And so I definitely feel that what you're doing is awesome. My question is, when your website pairs people together, are you keeping this locally initially, or how big are you expecting to expand?
For the beginning, we're going to try to keep it locally, but as soon as something grows, we might be able to do it, like, maybe actually
And what do you use to pair people together? Like, what is there some sort of program in place that?
Well, there's going to be a format that they put their information on, and they're going to have to write a little bit about themselves. And we're probably going to have people meet with them just to make sure, and then we'll put them on the website. Cool. Yes.
Yeah, what is your background? You're 15 years old. Now I'm going to take all that out of my room right now. Because I am so impressed by what you've done here. I personally was a young entrepreneur myself, and I respect where you're at, where you're coming from. I think your direction is very, very good. I think you have a lot to offer here. But as you said, you're just now being homeschooled. You changed your routine so that you can invest more time in this. With this, a lot of people are going to come to you, and I know you're 15 years old, you couldn't possibly know how to do all this. Tell us exactly how you started this out, where your concept came from, and how you saw this as something that you said, I can do this. Where did that come from?
All right, so I'm 1 of 8. I was always an active child, and as soon as I went to high school, I started messing up in school, and I started becoming discouraged and letting myself get down my grades and not keeping up with work. So as soon as that, we thought of different choices that I could make, and homeschool was one of them. And I live with my brother Mark, and he helped me out with a lot of things, and I work out with him daily. So doing this, I'm studying on how to teach people how to be fit, how to help people with their fitness plan, and how to keep them consistent and encourage them to keep going. And doing this, doing that, that's pretty much where I came from. I'm trying to, I wasn't fit at one point, and I'm not even that fit now. So that's why I'm trying to upload videos of me evolving just as much as everyone that's doing it at the same time.
Again, great job on the presentation. One thing that you probably get more in your generation than I do is the whole sensation over people around your age having these YouTube channels that get massive followings, and that's how they can build a brand and a business without having, you know, a big investment other than your time into it. Is there anything like that in the YouTube space? I mean, I know with yoga, right, there's like a million yoga YouTube channels, right? But is there something where instead of having some, you know, big fitness buff doing YouTube videos on how to work out and get in shape, where you could have something unique around that? Because you keep mentioning video, so that just strikes me as a way that rather than trying to compete against local gyms, why not have videos that the local gyms are actually promoting your videos, right? I mean, just an idea.
So soon enough, I have a YouTube channel, but I just haven't really uploaded yet, because this is still an idea and concept that hasn't really launched yet.
I have to say, one of the things that really jumped out at me is there's all these different things for boxes. This is getting kind of a little deeper into your presentation, but when you said you had the workout box, I thought that was awesome. I was like, oh wow, girls have merch boxes. You get fresh, you get food boxes. That would be awesome if I got a jump rope, new yoga mat, protein, cool new bar that was after. I'd be like, yes, I got my fitness box. And you had a little buddy, right, in my workout hall. Oh, that's super cool. And it would make me excited to feel like I'm getting a little present to work out. Outfits partnered with, even I had a girlfriend of mine post in her new yoga outfit this morning. She's like, I just got this yoga outfit and I'm so happy. How cool would that be if it came in a box and your friend got one and you would be pumped and you had a little profile. So, spark my thought, I just want to say that was super cool. I've heard that before.
I think you got a great idea. Preparing the people that have a common goal. Number two, Facebook connecting. And number three, Weight Watchers accountability. And you've kind of taken three amazing concepts, brought them together. I don't think you should be this passive about the idea. We're going to do. You've got a great idea. You should be looking up to someone to get this idea on paper, because this is something that someone else can take and run with. And there's a massive investment involved. And everything else going with it. So you're 15 years old, I know. You know millionaires that are 19, 20 years old with awesome ideas. You should get cracking on this. Hey, because you got an awesome idea. Great.
First of all, the guy that lost 55 pounds, I found at least 20 of those. If you want to get to it. When you're listing your competition, you're saying your competition is UFIT and Orange Theory and all of that. I don't know that I see that your competition. Your competition is part of the Fitbits and the Fit to Runs and the Nike Online Run. It seems like this is more of an online-based application. And the thing that makes this work for you is that it caters to the person that's not going to go to a gym. If they feel uncomfortable with themselves, they don't want to be judged. If they're doing it on their own, there's a reason. Biggest reasons people don't want to go to the gym. But if I can get paired up with somebody who's like-minded and motivates me, that's the motivation and that's the catch. My question though is, who's we? You said we a lot. Who's we? I'm just wondering if there's anybody else. Is there anybody else involved that really has a background in exercise physiology or nutrition?
Not yet.
Yeah. Yes. I'd like to hear more about your customer acquisition strategy, if you have one, and your target market. Is it, are you going to get your kids in your age group or lower? Or,
yes.
And I also have a comment. You might want to go back to school.
He's in school.
up, I'm going to try to target from ages 15 to 20, and then ages 20 to 25, and then ages 30 to 35, and then 40 and up, and then 60 and up. So, and then for each age group, we're going to have different workouts based on how athletic they are and what they can do and what they can achieve. Because you don't want to have to put a heavy set workout on someone that can't really do it. So that's why I'm going to try to match the workout with the person and with the group to keep it consistent.
So I think the choice to go home school is a great place for you.
Talk about linking those people together. that order completely. So maybe you should work on education, getting people together, building community first, and then slowly go technical when you need automation. Because really that's going to be like the foundation. So maybe like hosting events and maybe getting people together to eat at a healthy restaurant and stuff like that. And once you build that community, you can slowly transition to that type of stuff. And since everyone's talking about school, maybe going back to school is a good marketing use case for this.
Hey, so I'm super pumped that you're doing this, young man. I keep up the great work. It's like fantastic. And I think the one point of your business, sort of the principal point of your business where you have the accountability or accountability concept, I think if you keep leveraging that, that would be fantastic versus the personal trainer. You know, that's where I think you're different from Orange Fitness. But my question is, so what is your goal in 5 years and what is your goal in 10 years?
My goal in a year from now is to be achieved where people can know that I'm doing it right and they're doing it efficiently. And 5 years from now, me, give it all my own gym. And 10 years, I don't
know. Have you thought about going to get your personal trainer certification? I'm not sure if there's like an age requirement on that or not. But kind of to have that expertise behind your name so that when you are giving advice, people know that it's coming from, you know, a professional standpoint.
And I have thought about going to get my personal training degree, and I'm probably going to do research for a reason. So.
So the idea to do a YouTube channel is a really good idea. And while we were sitting here, I just did a few searches. And on YouTube, I did team workout and team fitness. All the videos there are over a year old, and some of them have 5,000 or 10,000. One has 300,000 views, and it was like team pump up. So there isn't a lot there. In the channels for team fitness, there's one or two videos each. So I think the opportunity on creating a YouTube channel is a good idea. I also did another little bit of research, and I went on the CDC, the Center for Disease Control and Prevention, and listen to this. In 2003, 14% of children in your age group were obese. Guess what it is now? It's almost 21%. So there are a lot more. Obesity is a problem. So your point of we're in this together, you can be that person if you're comfortable in front of the camera and you can make these videos. There is a tremendous opportunity, at least statistically, for you to do this. There certainly is a need according to our government. So, and don't forget, as soon as you start to get into 50, 60, 70,000 views, you start getting money, my man. So you can get paid by YouTube pretty quickly if you're this genuine, committed person that you are, and other kids who need your help, they need you. So I think that's a great idea, and statistics prove it. So my unsolicited advice to you is just start with YouTube. It doesn't take anything. You can do it for your brother, you can do it from the phone. You can edit things from your phone, and you keep that genuine self. I think you'll kill it. So, like, start tomorrow, dude. Like, seriously.
I just want to put a plug in for the Entrepreneurial Academy. As a graduate last year, that would give you a nice, well-rounded opportunity to go and learn a lot about running a business. And then you're also with like-minded people. There's about 20 people or so in the class that all have very much a lot of passion like you do about starting up a company. So that might be something to consider. It's 3 hours, I believe, on a Monday night. I don't know when they're starting lately, but something to consider as you're learning more about running a small business.
Practice or how you prepare for
flyer that's in those bags next Wednesday while supplies last a whole bunch of these. So a little motivation to come back and see us again next week.
Or if you wear the shirt.
Or if you wear the shirt. But how do we keep this room full of innovative entrepreneurs coming up with new ideas and getting feedback from the community? It's by telling other people that you were going to be here this morning. I saw some people taking photos, there's photos on our site. Take a photo before you leave. Tweet, post on social media, our hashtag is 1NCSDP. Just share with somebody that you're here if you saw this awesome new company starting with a 50-year-old entrepreneur today. Right? That will help bring more people back and grow this community and get more great presenters on that. If you're thinking about presenting, you're less than 4 years in business, less than $1 million in revenue, doing something innovative and scalable, you can either be at a, hey, this is what I'm thinking of doing today, I've got an initial presentation I want feedback on, or you could be, you know, 2 years in business and you're about to launch a new product and want some feedback on that. Go to one link up CMP, just Google this, find it on my recommended address, and